Hello everybody, welcome back for some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, and today we are going to go back into that mysterious looking door and see what we can go get figured out real quick, see what's going on with Riku and all that great stuff, and hopefully we'll have the chance to maybe meet up with Maleficent and maybe even be able to stop her finally. Who knows, we'll find out, won't we? So first things first, let's go ahead and take out these Wyverns real quick. I think that's what they were called. Something like that. And I want to talk to you folks out there just for a minute. It's about this. The Let's Play. So earlier on I said, like at the beginning, I was going to try to, you know, take down the super bosses. And if I couldn't do it, then I won't do it. Simple enough. I might do the same thing for, like, all the weapons, too. Because, you know, item grinding in this game is kind of a bitch. Because you need to get, like, so much... Some specific things, and yes, I know that Lucky Strike definitely helps, but the other thing too is dealing with all the stupid blue truffles and all those other extra like white mushrooms I have to find and get mystery goo that way, and it just would be more of a pain in the ass if I was to go full throttle on it. Of course, getting level 99 is going to be something that I'm not going to do. Well, granted, I would like to do it, but this is one of those kinds of games where I don't know, I just want to get on to something else. I don't want to have to spend so much time playing this one specific game all the time. And I know, it's an RPG, I get that. Since it is an RPG, you know, you should be a little bit more retracted to, like, actually wanting to do everything in it. But that's the thing, too. Like, if I was to do a Pokemon Let's Play, which I'm actually thinking about doing it, to be honest. If I was to do one, I'll probably end up trying to get, you know, the entire Pokédex completed. But... I wouldn't be able to get everything level 100. I wouldn't be able to get everything. You know, I'll try to get everything evolved and all that shit. But there's some things that you just can't do. Like, there's some things in the game that you can't actually complete in, like, a playthrough. Like, unless I just did, like, trading and stuff. There's outside help that goes into that. And well, depending on what game I play, I guess. Like, if I get all the way to, like, Black and White 2 or something like that, or Black and White in general, it's like I had to pick one or the other. And, you know, well, I can play both and just, like, trade shit and stuff like that, but I don't know, like, if I ever do a Pokemon game, which, like I said, I'm thinking about doing this year, that'd be great, this year or sometime soon. What I want to be able to do for you folks is, you know, be able to get the entire Pokédex completed. See, that's what I'm trying to do here, too. I mean, I know there's no Pokédex necessarily in this game, but there is, you know, Jiminy's Journal, and that's another thing, too, I have to worry about as well. You have to basically take down every single kind of Heartless that you see. And of course, there was those couple of specific Heartless I found. Now, there's nothing on my channel that directly says that I have to 100% every single living thing. And I'm pretty sure that most of you out there are probably like, alright Alex, just do what you need to do. Like, you know, if you want to do it, do it. If you don't want to do it, then don't do it. Then, you know, it's fine. I just get the feeling there's just some people out there who are probably going to be like, no, you have to do it because, you know, you said that you were willing enough to try it out, so therefore, that means that you need to do it. Now, that's the thing, too. Like, I'm afraid that somebody might say that, too. It's like, well, Alex did say he would like to try to attempt to fight all the mini, you know, super bosses. And it's like, well, he might as well, like, 100% it. That way he can just get that done with, and now he fell all the fucking way back down here. Now... From a Let's Player's sake, you know, I keep back and forthing about this too. Like, I keep thinking, like, should I get the ultimate weapon? Should I get all the staves and the staffs? Or what do they call it? The shields and the staffs? There's something called, like, a stave. I don't know. Well, anyway, like, should I get every weapon, you know? Like, I've never done it before, either. And usually when I do, like, a Let's Play, it's like, I try to have at least some idea of what the hell I'm doing. And that's the case with Kingdom Hearts 1 right now. It's like, I have an idea of what I'm doing. A Chain of Memory isn't going to be totally... Oh, fuck that. I'm not going to 100% that game. I'm not going to get everything in that game. Not level 99, none of that crap. That just, to me, just... No. That's not a bad game. It's just, I don't want to go through all of that grinding. Now, like I said before, when it comes down to, like, doing a Pokemon game or whatever, I might just get, like, one freaking Pokemon, like, level, you know, 100. At least, maybe. It depends on, like, which one I start with and, like, how quickly I can go through it. If I decide to play it off-screen and grind a little bit, then, you know, whatever. My problem with grinding off-screen in this game and it kind of goes in the same with like most RPGs, is there tends to be things that I will actually get out of leveling up that I want to show off to you folks. But that's the thing too, like I don't want to do it off screen and then like have to remember exactly what I'm going for or what I got out of it too. And it's just, it's more of a pain in the ass. Okay, here's what it is. It's more of a pain in the ass if I actually do it. If I'm actually able to do it, then fine, whatever. You know, if I actually was able to complete this completely, that would be awesome. Fuck yeah. But you guys gotta realize it's more of a pain in the ass on my end to do this kind of stuff too. Now, don't get me wrong. Leveling up, if I just stay here for a little bit, I might have a good chance of actually getting a pretty decent level. Like you saw earlier, I leveled up. So it's not like I can't get level 99, it's just I don't want to get level 99. So, if I did say I was going to do it, well then I'm sorry. You know, I'm not trying to come off like a hypocrite or anything like that. It's just you have to understand that this fucking game is long as shit. And more, you know, actually the cool thing is, I'm pretty sure that everybody who's probably watching this game right now has probably played this game themselves. I'm pretty sure that you folks out there already have an idea of what is going to happen. I'm pretty sure most of you have seen plenty of Kingdom Hearts playthroughs and you're like, yeah, there's really no point in getting everything because you can... You can beat the game with relative ease just by doing what I'm doing, which is just running around and, you know, hoping for the best. Just trying to hang in there and get everything completed. And these motherfuckers are going to follow me. Okay, so I need to figure out, is there actually... I don't think there's a blue Trinity around here anywhere, but there might be. There are some things, obviously, that I went for. Like all the Trinity marks and stuff like that. Although I have not completed them completely. But I'm definitely working my way up to there. I would like to get the games completed, too. So, whenever we get the chance, I want to go back and do... I want to go back to the Colosseum and get some of that shit done as well. That way, I just have it done and finished, if I'm able to finish it. And see, when it comes to Kingdom Hearts 2, that's one... That's another thing I'm afraid of doing, too, is Kingdom Hearts 2, because... With the games, like, I'm level 99 in that game, and... It's pretty easy level up, but, like, I'm level 99 so far, right? And, frickin', the thing is... Even though I'm level 99, I still can't beat the Lingering Will. I suck. That's pretty obvious. I can't beat... I can't finish the last Colosseum because I suck at that too. So there's something... It's just like, what would you rather have to put up with? Like, would you folks out there would rather just see me go through everything possible and just, you know... I don't know, like... Okay, you know what? No, I don't know. There's games out there that I'm willing to 100%, and, you know, I also need to change the titles of, like, my Uncharted series, because, like, I don't get all the skins, I don't get all the cheats, so that's not technically 100%, but I did get all the treasures in those games, the ones I've done so far, which is just the first two. But the good thing is, like, at number three, like, I don't know, like, some people take 100% to, like, great lengths. Like, some people classify, like, you know, like, oh yeah, beat multiplayer might be like 100%. It's like, no, it's not. That's something totally different. I don't know, like, here's how I see it. I see there's 100% and then there's, you know, plus 100%. Like, there's like 110% or something like that. Most games have that. Like, Crash Bandicoot. I go off Crash Bandicoot logic here, folks, where it's like, oh, if I get everything extra, then it's 110%. You know, it's 101% extra. It's not really a big deal. Same thing with Spyro, where it's like, oh, I can get that stuff, or I can just get all the collectibles that's around and just beat the game that way and not have to worry about all the stupid skill points or anything like that. Like, I love when games do that, where they give you that option of 100%, where it's like, well, you can easily 100%, but there's more. You know, it's like, oh yeah, do you want to go get more and actually fully complete the game, or you just want to 100% the game? It's like, eh. 100% to me is technically completion, so I'm good with that. Depending on the game at hand, of course. I mean, there are games out there that I do want to, like, fully invest my time in and, like, actually complete all the way. But those are very rare. Like, I would love to, you know, be able to beat Crash with, like, 120 or whatever percent it is. But those games are freaking ridiculous. Well, mainly, I'm talking about 3. 2, no, it's fine. Well, there's no relics or anything like that in 2, so it's no really big deal. Now, that's gonna move that. Where? Just move it? Okay. So I guess that one's going to move, so you can take that if you need to. I wanted to take this elevator thing right here, but I also wanted to take the other platform too, because I know... I think this is the way we need to go. Yeah, and I want to get back on that other platform, because like that platform doesn't take me anywhere, it just moves me around. So I want to get back on that real quick. When I get on that, I'll just go from there. Alright, let's see here. So yeah, basically, like I said, I'm going to try my best to do the best I can. If I can't do it, then, oh well. You know, things happen. I can't 100% every single, like, game I do. I'm bringing this up now because I feel like I'm ripping off people somehow. Like, I feel like people are probably, like, they're watching this because they want to see me complete it completely. And it's like, well, I can't. I can, but I don't know how to do it. And, I can just look them online. But then again, like, wouldn't that take away from, well, I've done that already. I already looked up a few things online. Anyway, I don't know. Like, here's my thing. I'm trying to complete this for you folks. That's good enough for me. Just give you guys, you know, a nice easy story going on here, so you guys can enjoy that. Let's see what Omega Ether give me out of it. Nothing! Gives me shit! Actually, let's go ahead and use an Ether real quick. On myself? Oh, that's true, because, like, Mega Ether only gives you... It gives the entire party, like, Ethers, but it gives you, like, three, because, like, you're giving it to the entire party, so it's like, what's the point? Yeah, I don't know, like, I'll play the way I want to play, and that'll just be enough for me. And I hope that's enough for you folks out there, too, because... Really, you have to understand that this is going to be... I knew coming into this that this was going to be a long one. It was going to be a long one for sure. And, you know, it's proved itself. Like, it's already, like, 40 parts in. Now, I'm going to attempt to try to take down the super bosses. I know where, like, three of them are at, and I think that... Well, one of them I don't actually know how to get. Like, I'm not sure how to get him to come up. I know where he's at. I just don't know how to get him to trigger out, so... Or, you know, be able to fight him, pretty much. I want to say something real quick. How many more of those damn blue ones do I have? I think I have two. Okay, cool. Well, the question is, where are those last two? I know where one is, and the next one, I don't know where the last one's at. I can always just look that up and just go get it. Not off screen. I'll do it on screen so I can show you guys where I got it at, but yeah. Yeah, another thing is, too, like, there's games that have hard mode and stuff like that as well, and I don't go through these games on hard mode being that way to get, like, a full completion grade or anything like that. It's just like, oh, hey, you know, it's something there for, like, a personal reason. It's like, well, it's more of, like, a personal kind of thing to do. It's like, well, you know, I can 100% it. Or, you know, I can 100% it and go beat it on freaking, you know, hard difficulty and stuff like that. Proud mode, pretty much. In this game's case. So that's on the next Blue Trinity Mark. There's still one out there that I need to go find. What I always could do, like I said, is I can always just go look it up and find it that way. I want to see something real quick. I don't see any chests. Do you? I don't see nothing. Alright. So I guess the only choice we have is to take this elevator up. And it's going to poof us right there. Alright, kick ass. Any more chests around here? No, I don't see any. Oh, I also want to get the Dalmatians too. There's a lot of things I want to show off and get. And of course, you know, there's a lot of things that I probably won't be able to get as well. Actually, real quick, let's see how many Dalmatians I have left, to be honest. I am missing 52 through 57, 61 to 63, so I'm missing 6. Well, I think at least 6 chests, I think. Wait a minute, what'd that say? Hold on, go back to that. Don't tell me. Oh, fuck you, it does tell you where they're at. There's 6 in Monstro, there's 3 in Hollow Bastion, and there's 3 in Argiva. Oh, fuck me. That exists. Yeah, but you can't do it here. I'm hitting triangle. It's not... Okay, cool. So now I know that I need to go back to Agrabah. I need to go back to... Well, I'm in a Hall of Bastion now. What the hell else was there? There was 6 in Monstro. That's right. So we'll go get those 6 in Monstro. Like the game said, there was like a certain ability I need. So I'll just go look that up, you know, on the off chance. And like when we get the chance to go back, I'll go do that. If anything, I can always just like cut... Whenever I look it up, let's cut there and just cut into it. That'll work. Yeah, that'd be a smart idea to do. Wouldn't be too bad. Wouldn't be too unprofessional. It'd just be something that everybody pretty much does. Alright, so. That takes care of that, and we're still not done. God damn it. I want these guys dead. I want to take out... Well, actually, what I could do is this. Go ahead and use magic on that now. And then not worry about it. Just have it down here, at least. At least that way I have it. So, let's go ahead and get it. This might be Dalmatians, I hope. Nope, it's a Thundara ring. Alright, sweet. The Dalmatians are... Where are they, actually? From the top of my head, I don't remember where they're at. They might be in that big blockade thing, though, but no, that's probably not it, because I think that block... That other block that I need to go to... you know, I have to lift down, I think leads me into, like, the main area we need to go to. So, we'll find this freaking Dalmatian in here somewhere, and we'll go back, and we'll go get the other Dalmatians I missed. We'll go back to Traverse Town, go take care of that, and then after that, you know, we'll do all that good stuff. You know, it's funny, okay, so the reason why I never hit triangle in the main menu was because I was thinking it was like, oh yeah, show me a... You know how, like, when you go to, like, the heart, like, check out the heartless, you can press triangle and find it that way? Yeah, that's what I was thinking that was. So that's what screwed me up. Oh, shit. That's what screwed me up on that one, was I thought that hitting triangle wouldn't do anything, because I figured triangle was already set in the journal to, like, showing, like, a character diagram or whatever it was. That's what had me thinking, like, oh, never hit triangles. Like, what's the point? But now I know. And knowing is only half the battle. Come on, you son of a bitch. Oh my god, okay. So watch out when he does thunder, though, clearly. I mean, we've been seeing that for like the past 10 minutes now, Alex, so I'm pretty sure everybody knows. But anyway, like, just be a little worried, or just be a little careful when they use thunder, because they tend to block off your attacks for some reason. Why they do that with thunder, I don't know. I mean, I guess it makes sense, because it gives them an ability to use, so alright, fair enough, but thunder of all things, I don't even know. Now, there shouldn't be a chest in here. I don't see one, though. Yeah, I don't see a chest, but there's... No, that's nothing. Alright, so back to the high tower. Here we go. Now let's go get this next spot taken care of. First, there's a chest up above that I want to get. But Sora will not lock onto it, and it's getting on my nerves. I'm going to go ahead and just gravity him, because when you gravity, like, the defenders, it helps so much in this game. Like, it seriously does. Oh, goodness. We're getting actually a lot of experience, though, too, which is nice. Hey, and that's the good thing about going full throttle with, like, Dead of Night, because I'm actually able to level up relatively quickly. Like, it's not cheesing the game, necessarily. It's just, like, do you either level up quickly in the beginning of the game or, you know, at the end? And I want to level up at the end of the game, because that way, you know, I can just go through it, and if, like I said before, like, if... Or, I don't know if I said it exactly this way, but... Anyway, if I need to off-screen, I'll off-screen. How about that, okay? Let me just say that now. If the off-screen opportunity comes around and I need to do it, then I'll do it. But if I don't need to do it, or if I don't need to worry about it, then I won't do it. Simple enough. Okay, now, next up, let's see. I think there's... Yeah, there's a platform there that I need to get to, clearly. So let's go ahead and take out these Pokemon rejects real quick, and then after we get rid of these assholes... I want to go ahead and see if I can get up that platform. Well, I'm sure I can. I just don't remember how to get up there. Hey, at least I remembered it was back there. So give me credit. At least I knew it. Yeah, we can't get up there unless... Well, see, there's something... There's a line that goes... No, that's not going to work. So what does this one do? This one will... Oh, that's right. Oh, okay. Cool. So we got that to work. Now we just head back up here. And I'm sure there's going to be some Heartless that are going to spawn. Of course... At the wrong damn moment, they always have to spawn. And the worst part is, these motherfuckers, I can't use magic on. And the problem is, also, if I fall down, guess what? I'm stuck. I have to come right back up here. Well, yeah, I can glide. I know that much. But this is not Neverland, so I can't just fly back up here, which would be nice. Oh, shit. Come on. You know, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get the Pokemon this year, because... This year is going to be like me just doing RPGs and stuff. I know I'm dying, guys. Don't worry. I got it. Like, this year is going to be me doing like an RPG after every just like basic game. So, if every RPG I do, about said, every RPG I does, if every RPG that I do happens to be, you know, Kingdom Hearts or Paper Mario length long, then more than likely we're going to be running into some troubles with trying to get as many RPGs into this year as I possibly can. But it's more than likely my RPG mood is probably going to go ahead and just... It's going to move in, like, all the way into, like, freaking, just doing, you know, like, a lot of games. Like, even into, like, next year, it might even just go straight into there. Like, I might just keep doing this for a while. You know, an RPG after every basic game, you know, well, by basic, I mean, like, you know, every, like, irregular... Every non-RPG, pretty much. So why is RPGs like the big case of like me doing it as its own kind of set of marathoning, pretty much? Well, the thing is, RPGs are long as shit, and they're fun too. Well, hang on. I'll tell you later.
So, I see the path has emerged at last.
Yes. The keyhole to the darkness.
Unlock it, and the Heartless will overrun this world.
What do I care? The darkness holds no power over me. Rather, I will use its power to rule all worlds.
Such confidence.
Oh. Ah! Impossible! The Princesses of Heart are all here! It must be her.
Without her heart, she will never be able to release her power.
The King's fools are here. I'll deal with them myself. You stay here and guard the princesses.
Okay, so before we go any further, I'm gonna go back real quick and I wanna go see what that change of elevator thing is gonna actually help me with. Well, it's not really an elevator, but you know what I mean. I'm gonna go back. We're gonna have to fall down for a little bit here, folks. When we get back down there, I wanna go ahead and change. I wanna see something real quick. So, it comes from there. So let's go find it. Actually, it comes from all the way up there. Or no, it goes inside there, though. But where does it come from? That's the question. I don't even know myself. Like, I can't figure out where I need to go to get that thing to work. Maybe that'll come into play later. Like, I'm pretty sure we come back for it later. More than likely. Don't worry about, like, necessarily beating this game. I think there's, like, another world we get to go to later on. If anything, what I could do before I actually go and take care of Maleficent herself, I can always go back real quick. And, like, in the next video, I'll start the next video and let's go back real fast and we're gonna go do some extra stuff. I know I keep going back and forth with this plot and, like, doing extra shit. But at the same time, folks, it's like, might as well do it, you know, while I got the chance. So we're gonna go back. We're probably gonna go back to the Coliseum, go do some games. We're gonna go get the rest of the Dalmatians, which, actually, no, let's... I don't know. You know what? No, I might just stick with this, actually. I'll stick with this, and if there comes a point, which I think there is, a point where I can actually just go back before it's too late. I'll go back before it's too late and just go deal with that shit. So, basically what I'm probably going to do is not grind. I mean, grinding would be nice to do, believe me. Don't get me wrong. I would love to do that. But it's just, why do it now? Because, like, if I'm not going to, like, complete the game totally, it's just, like, what's the point? So, I don't know. I'm not trying to be, like, pessimistic or negative. I'm just trying to say, like, honestly, this is not like a full throttle, you know, super awesome fucking kick-ass RPG, or... No, it is a kick-ass RPG. I'm trying to say, like, it's not a really super kick-ass freaking, you know, like, let's go in and just beat the living shit out of everything in sight. Maybe we can get that damn thing to spawn here, though. Let's go try it out real quick. No, that was, yeah, yeah, okay, I gotcha. So that brings that down. There's really no point in doing that. What... Hold on, I want to see what this thing does first. I think it brings me back down. Wherever it brings me, I'll get back up here, no problem. I'll get back up here and we'll continue on our little way. I don't think I have any more journal entries to read about. So this might be another regular short video again. Maybe I got Lucid Crystal, kick ass. Yeah, this might be just another, you know, basic short video or anything. I would like to get to the point where I can actually save the game and hopefully get all my shit back. I need to go ahead and turn on some items, or put on some items, I should say. Oh, fuck yeah, max HP up, sweet. I kind of like how it looks now, because like my MP bar and my HP bar are like at the same spot. They're like even. That's awesome. So I'm going to go ahead, and like the last few minutes of this video, I'm going to go ahead and get some kills going in here. Just got an extra level. We leveled up twice this video. That's pretty good. Like I said, that Dead of Night thing totally freaking helps. Seems to me like, oh, we got Lucky Strike. Fuck yeah, dude. fucking Donald finally got it. Okay, hang on. Let's go ahead and kill this asswipe. I don't know. I'll take a look around. I'll see what I can find if... Ah, shit. No. No, because I remember reading somewhere that you can actually... There's going to be a point of, like, no return. I know that. But where was it at is what I'm trying to figure out. I need Lucky Strike, but fucking second win, go away. No, just get rid of it. Thank you. Lucky Strike. Hell yeah, Lucky Strike for him. Goofy has it too. Somewhere. Actually, Goofy can put on a lot of shit. He's actually been leveling up. I just not been paying attention. No, does he? Yes, he has Lucky Strike. Evolution, give up MP to give 30 HP to the entire party. Second win, second chance, MP Rage, MP Gift. And Berserk, boosts attack power when HP is critically low. Well, they usually get killed off a lot. You know, I'm going to give them both Berserk as well. Yeah, we'll do that. Donald, can't do anything with him. Sora, I can give myself another air combo boost. Yeah, we can do that, actually. All right, sweet. So that's going to be it for this, folks. I hope you all enjoyed, and we'll see you all next time when we play some more Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. Sometime, we're going to go back, get all the Dalmatians. We're going to go find the last trainer jump sometime, too. I want to go find that. I'm going to look up both videos for it, figure out where the fuck they are, and I will see you all next time. So take care, everybody.